from Zambia, you are well welcome to this health issues, health seminar, and I hope you learn something from there. We also have some people from Burundi. If we have some people from Burundi, you are well welcome, and together we're going to share some experiences. You have people from Rwanda, and I can see some people from South Africa, from Namibia, and we have some very few, or majority are from Tanzania. I'm speaking to you. I'm Dr. Allen, by Professor Dr. Allen Massam, and I'll take you through this program, almost 1 hour. It will be, we'll be finished about these issues. And today, as the title said, we are going to talk about the health issues related to the men. Men's health matters a lot. We all know about the men that have the very good health, and we are going to go through the health related to men issues. And this training is not for the men. Also, women is very more important, even more than the men, I can say. And because today, I know if time allows, we can also have some few questions. And we know that to have a very good healthy, a human being or a man or a man, generally, we have to balance. There should be a balance between money and health. Very important issues. Now, in this life, if these two things never balance, then there must be some challenges. And today, we'll see what things maybe we can do so as we can balance. Thereafter, I'll show you a way on how to balance between these two things, between money and health. Yeah, and as the matter of the issue of the health is concerned, we have the public health issues. You know, we have the challenges around us due to the environmental issues. We have some infectious diseases those are the public issues. We also have some issues related to the environmental issues, but also we have some other issue to the nature of the human, maybe the way we drink tea or the way we use our surroundings, also surrounded with the chronic diseases. So these are the factors that together they bring out the health issues. Now we are going to strike among those issues, but also we have some toxins and environmental issues together with the obesity issues. Those are the things that mostly affect our health. But also we have aging, the issue about the aging, we can also go through these things. But to have a very good health, those things together, they bring out to the stress in our mind. Now having the stress, now these stress issues, they impair our health in general, and thereafter, that's why we normally don't have a very good health due to this stress and the other issue that I stressed earlier. But also due to the stress and other issues, it end up with the obesity. You know, the obesity, this one has been the very big challenging factor or challenging parameter. Due to the obesity, there are some other challenges, any other diseases that are associated with the obesity. Obesity is more than overweight, and there are a number of diseases that are associated with obesity, being maybe just by mentioning a few of the diseases. We have hypertension, we have heart diseases, we have diabetic type 2, we have also joint issues, osteomyelitis, arthritis, and others. So those are the challenges that we face due to this a very giant health problem that is being obesity or being obese. So it's very important to know exactly what to do so as we can live a very good health. So, but also we have some other factors due to those challenges. They bring out with another challenges, that is the aging. You see, the matter of fact that we know the factors that associated, that contribute to the aging. That's why we have people aging differently, even if they have the same age. But we also have people that they age at the, I mean, it, at a very high speed as compared to others. These are the some few factors that contribute or the, that they lead to speed up your aging. And just to mention a few of them, we have the pollution due to the environmental issues. We have this lifestyle issues about the drinking, alcohol drinking, the use of the drugs. Any medication also, the too much use of the drugs or medications, they also speed up the aging, but also the use of the of tobacco, but also the stress and the other weight gain and weight loss. But the very, very important issues about the diet. Now, having the very good diet at one point, moderate or just maintain the your age and slow up your the rate of of aging. By the way, those are the some few factors which also affect health. But also due to those issues, it end up to have the health challenges as the man as the matter of fact that we are dealing with the main health issues today. Now we have another issues. This is very, very big. That's the male infertility. Now, with the statistics, it shows that we have a very good number of infertility, not only in Tanzania or in Zambia or in any other country. This is the worldwide issues. And there are so many, there are numbers of, the number of issues that they may contribute to the male infertility. Just to mention few of them, as I mentioned earlier, some other medications, we have this lifestyle changes, I mean, lifestyle issues, smoking and everything, but also we have the use of the chemo and radiotherapy issues. They also contribute to a certain point to speed up or to activate the infertility. But also we have a medical history, this is such as diabetic mellitus, hypertension. They also contribute to the male infertility. But also we have, previously we had some medical examinations that they lead to toxins in our body. So those are some few issues that they can contribute to male infertility. But not only that one, we have another area, very good area. This is the prostate issue. It's very important. I know some of you know about the prostate, a prostate gland. Now, when talking of the health in men's particularly, we have to strike the area of this prostate. Prostate is just a gland. It's the gland which is surrounded, it is located between the urethra and the bladder, but also it has the function of producing some fluid which specifically aid or support the flow of the sperm. Now, in any health challenged state, that's very dangerous to a man. So it's very, very important that we take care of our prostate. Now we have another, we have some health challenges affecting the prostate, and we can just discuss some few of them. Now you can see the bladder. This one is the urinary bladder, and this is the prostate gland. It is located between the bladder. This one is the tube that brings them. The urine from the bladder to outside. Now the prostate is clearly located here, and between this this prostate, it passes some two tubes. One just bring those semen, the fluid, but the other one passes the urine. Now the health challenges related with the prostate, they associated or they come up from this prostate. And we can see later on, we'll just go through those challenges, the different conditions that affect the prostate. Just by mention of them, we have three major prostate conditions, one of which being enlarged prostate, as I showed you earlier. The prostate enlargement, this one is the very very common condition. It occurs from how it happens to a man. Any man has the chance to have prostate enlargement just from the 40 years and above. Some from 45 years and above, they tend to have the enlarged prostate. Now we have the health challenges associated with the prostate enlargement, but also we have prostate and prostate infection. That's what we call prostatitis. Prostatitis is just simply the infection of the prostate. Now, that's another health challenge, but also the prostate can also have the cancer, the prostate cancer. You know, the cancer can happen at any point. Now, these are the three major conditions that can affect the prostate. Now, by seeing this one is the picture of the prostate, that's showing the normal prostate gland, having this one urethra. Now is the where the semen or the sperm that maybe can pass through here. Now this one is the prostate, the normal prostate gland. Now you can see when the prostate enlargement happens or occurs, now there are some health challenges. I mean the health challenges or the there are something that you can experience due to the enlarged upper prostate. One of which, of course, it just enlarged inward and outwards. Now there will be a narrowing of this urethra, but also the more prostate enlargement occurs, the more the narrowing occurs. Then now you can easily know the symptoms or the symptom that you can experience anybody having this prostate enlargement. Now you can see. Now, how can you know that you have a prostate enlargement? Simply, there are something that you can feel. One of it being a painful ejaculation, because it's the place that passes that a semen. So the space has been narrowed. So during the sexual intercourse, you can have a painful ejaculation, but also you can have a burning urination. But also you can have sometimes blood in urine or sometimes blood in semen. Those are the things that you can experience. But also you can have a frequent eager to urinate because of the narrowing of that urethra. So anyone experience these things, it's very, very important to just go for the checkup, because you might have a prostate enlargement. But not only prostate enlargement, there are some other medical conditions that can associate with these symptoms. Because not only just urinate maybe overnight, maybe two or three times, but also you can have another medical issue. So it's very, very important to go for the checkup. So as you say, those are medical issues, medical practitioners can exactly know what is happening to your body. Now, those are the simple things that they can happen to prostate due to the pro. Now, this signs they can appear to anybody with the prostate enlargement, but also with prostate cancer can also present with these symptoms. Very few. Sometimes you can have a painful or pain. At the lower back, you can have the pain at the hips and pelvic. Those are the areas that we can experience the pain during having these healthy challenges. But also now, when having these things, it's very, very important, as I said earlier, to go for the medical checkup. And if you have those things, there are a number of examinations they can just use in the maybe the blood, or they can just use in the other issues just for the checkup. But we also have the very common. This one is the rectal examination. Whenever you have a prostate enlargement, so you must go through this process of rectal examination. The rectal examination is not a very interesting procedure, but also it has two. Now the rectal examination, this one the clinician or the medical personnel will clearly insert his or her finger through the rectum to go deep inside and feel and palpate the prostate so as the maybe he or she could know exactly if there is enlargement or there is any change of the prostate. Now it's very, very important to take good care of your health so as not to be subjected to this procedure. It's not very good. You can see now anybody can just be subjected to this area, and the rectal examination can easily be performed. Now, those are the things that can happen to anybody. So it's very, very important to make sure you take good care of yourself before reaching at that point. But also we have another issues. This is of infections. Now, one of the, another factor for men's challenges, that is infection. We have sexual transmitted diseases. We have this one. There are so many, there are a number of these sexually transmitted diseases. We can have syphilis, you can have gonorrhea, but good things that these are the things that they can be managed, they can be treated easily. Now those are the other factor that can contribute to the man's health. But also now through in sexually transmitted diseases, there are a number of things that they can contribute, or they can cause those infections. Maybe it can be bacterial infections. We have a number of bacteria that can affect you, or can infect any man. So bacterial infections, the very common one is gonorrhea. Gonorrhea, we have a virus in a viral infection, we have HIV. Those are the things that anybody can just encounter. But also you have fungus and the parasite. These are the infections that any man can get and have infected. But also we have another health challenges. This is male infertility, and through the male infertility there are also by the way, for the male infertility, unfortunately or fortunately enough, it usually has no symptoms. So you cannot easily see someone and say that maybe you are just infected. So to notice these things, the medical examination has to be performed, and normally they can just do a semen analysis they can just check for the hormones and the blockage of the reproductive tract. Those are the signs and the symptoms. So basically, if you are not fertile enough, so you cannot clearly tell just by looking, and you can sometimes not have any symptoms, or you cannot experience anything. So unless they do a medical examination. So now, but we have causes. We have some factors which causes male infertility. Just few of them, the factors that can contribute to the male infertility, they can be categorized in different groups. One of which being sperm problems. Now, during the sperm problems, we can have a trauma maybe through the tubes, but we can have another diseases. We have diabetes also. Diabetes also contribute to the sperm problems, but also we have sexual transmitted diseases. They also affect the sperm problems, but also we have the obesity. Now, obesity also it has a very good chance of affecting of interfering the sperm issues, but genetic disorders. This one, of course, genetic disorders also have issues. So you can see that we have a number of factors that contribute to the male infertility. But we have a number of factors. But now we can group them in different categories. Now, this one is the normal. Now you can have this one is just the man. With the normal anatomy. Now the problem or the challenge can occur at any place. Maybe it can appear before the testing. Before the testing, that we call pre-testicular causes. Those are the things that they appear. They occur. Before the testing. And we have the other one which appear post after the test, but also the testicular causes, but also they have the factors that they are due to the sperm related factors, just being the structure of, the structure of the shape of the sperm, being the mobility of the sperm. Of course, those are the things that they can be categorized, or the that we can categorize, or we can group those challenges, particularly due to the testicular causes, but also causes, the other causes that I explained earlier. Those are the testicular factors. We have the genetic, they can have the congenital issues, but also we have immunological issues, but also we have the issues related with the hormones, together with the, those things that they can just appear through, due to the obstruction of the vessels and everything. Those are the things that they can cause a testicular problems. But also we have the other very big issues of a man that affect our health. This is masturbation. Yeah, masturbation, when just going, we have a very good question here, by the way. Is masturbation good for you or not? And these things, it has been performed during, before or during, maybe when we are very little, starting from maybe two years or sometime 1 year, a baby can just practice a masturbation. And then we normally go through it till maybe 5 years, but other people they can quit the habit of masturbation, but other people they can just go on with the masturbation. And we have some people, the number of people that are in the marriage, but they're still doing the masturbation. And by the way, the masturbation, just reading about the science of masturbation through the Google and everywhere, they explain it very good, as if they're very something very good. But in actual sense, masturbation is very bad to our health. It's very bad, and it has the very challenging issues in reproduction, not only in men's health, but also women's also. It has some very big complications. So masturbation is something very bad, something to we have to stress it, and we have to do a very something very, to make sure that these things, it is stopped. We have some people that in the schools and the colleges, they are just doing this masturbation, because masturbation is just a self-satisfaction, sexual satisfaction. People, they use some other, they use some agents, some they use some object to self satisfy themselves sexually. So there are a number of complications, and there are complications due to over masturbation also. So masturbation is something very bad to our health, masturbation, you can see this one is just stimulation of some nerves and everything, so as you can be satisfied sexually, but it has some other mental complications, but also we have it also have some issues in sexual, in health related. Also it cause it also interfere with failure to reach the climax type, by the way, I will tell it more. But also we have another health condition. This is overweight. Overweight, of course, is another health challenges. Now, some people they look like this one. Now, having this one, don't expect to be in a very good health with this shape. Now, sometimes also you don't look good. You don't look good, but also health-wise, you can fail. You can even fail to perform some other issues due to the way people we are. So it's very very important to work on our weight. By the way, we striking on another health issues. We have this one is erectile dysfunction. Erectile dysfunction. This one is failure. This one is characterized by the inability to develop or maintain an erection or penis during sexual performance. We have a very good numbers of people that they fail to erect and to perform sexual intercourse correctly. We have a number of erectile dysfunction, a number of one of it being old, I mean, age, it goes with age, that people with the older age, they have the high chances of failing to erect normally, but also we have some issues related with the stress and the anxiety also. It also contributes contribute to the erectile dysfunction. But also we have a premature ejaculation. Premature ejaculation, this one can be categorized into two groups. We have physical reasons. We have the biological reason that affect the premature ejaculation. Premature ejaculation, some people they can ejaculate very early, maybe during the preparation, or some people they can just ejaculate just before the penile penetration when they practice the sexual intercourse. But also we have someone can ejaculate some few minutes after the penetration. Now those are the early ejaculation. We have this research was performed in different countries, and they came up with this data. The data showed that different couples have performing the sexual intercourse, and they calculated the time. After the penis penetration, then before just before the to and fro motion, they just started counting, and they did of course the time, the stopwatch and everything, so that they can know how long will everyone ejaculate. So after that study, majority of people landed happier 5 to 6 minutes. Five to six minutes, up to 10 minutes, you can see the data there. But very few, they just go up to 40 minutes. So now after this data of timing, the time for ejaculation, now they came up with this conclusion that we have the average time. It's just 4 minutes to 11 minutes. So majority, they ejaculate between 4 to 11 minutes. So anyone just ejaculate less than this one, that one is a very big challenge. But we also have some people that they can just go even more than that. But doesn't mean that if you can take 20 minutes before ejaculation, that is not normal. It's very normal, but very few people, they can take longer, and thereafter we see what we can do, so as we can control this number of ejaculation time. But also we have this scenario. We can see some people that they just when practicing with, maybe when you are with your partner, very few minutes. You see, so someone is just close to start, and you are finished by the way. That's very very bad issue. But also now those are they can appear. You see, those are the things. You see, you can see someone is ready to start, but the other one is finished already. So those are the premature ejaculation. Now it's very, very important to work on them. And you can see what causes those premature ejaculation. Those are just the normal life cycle that we are living, the food that we are taking, the lifestyle that we are living. You see, not only the food, but the lifestyle. We are people that we are not doing some physical exercise, the diet, the food that we are taking, we are consuming. So those things, the stress that we are having, they all contribute to those things. And now when these things happens or surround us, our body act as absorb as I mean it, our body simply absorb those things in our environment. We can see maybe we are surrounded with the different issues. Now, when our body absorbs those things, they just come up with this issue of free radicals or simply toxins. Now, toxins are the accumulation of any unwanted issues to your body. Now, those things, they can also cause, they are the causes of the of those health challenges. They are the causes of the disease. They are the cause of everything. Now, when talking of toxins or simply free radicals, now those are the things that we should clearly talk of them and combat them in a very serious matter. Now, when our body absorb all those things, they go up to the toxins, and those simply we can call them are free radicals. Now, the free radicals. Now, this one is an example of the free radicals or oxidation. Is a structure of an apple, now showing that the normal structure of an apple, but this one is the one which the process of oxidation has been taking place, but it has absorbed the oxygen and changed a little bit to other nature. Now you can take an example of the normal diseases. This is the scenario that explains how the disease occurs, by the way, because of the oxidation process. Now this one is the normal, as I said, together with the oxidation occurs. It simply shows the structure or the conditions occurring there. Now those are in normal structure we have a health atom. This one is the normal cell of anything, maybe of an atom or our normal cell. But also we have those are free radicals. Free radicals, those are the toxins simply. Now we have the way of combating of removing these free radicals, just with the help of the antioxidant. Antioxidant, these are the small elements that are, they have high affinity to these free radicals. Now, when exposed to antioxidant, then they tend to attach to this one and leave this the normal health in a very good health condition. Then, so the importance of of antioxidants in our daily life is just to remove these free radicals. And free radicals, just remember, simply just the toxins that we are surrounded with them. And those toxins, we can see this the way an apple change from the normal to to this bad structure. That one is it's a chemical change, or it's a reaction. Simply it shows that this one thereafter it changed to this shape. It can also appear or occurs to our normal our body also. So our body, simply the cell can change from the normal cell. It can be attacked with any free radicals and change its shape to get this one. So as the disease occurs, the scenario of the disease, so it's very, very important to combat or to work on this, the free radicals. You can see this one is the normal face. This one is the very normal. This one has been attacked with those oxygen. It has been, oxidation process has been occurred here. The same as if it appears on your face or on your skin, shows the process, the way it appears. Now the free radicals, there are some factors which contribute to the free radicals. Being alcohol contributes a lot to the free radicals. We have a poor diet contribute to the radicals. The normal life that we are living contribute to the free radicals. Sometimes lack of sleep also can contribute to the free radicals. Obesity can also contribute to the free radicals, smoking and everything. So those are the things that contribute to the free radicals. And as I said earlier, it's very important to work and to focus on how to combat those free radicals. And as I said, the use of antioxidant is very, very important for the removal of those free radicals. Now, Now, what this one shows that the outcomes of the free radicals, the outcome of the free radicals simply is the diseases. Now, when you have accumulation of these free radicals to your body, simply show that you have some other, it can lead to other diseases such as heart attacks, such as cancer, such as aging, or issues of the joints because of the free radicals. So free radicals are the sources of all the diseases that you know. So it's very, very important. So when we combat these free radicals, simply we combat or we focus on those diseases. We also have some other lifestyle diseases such as a stroke and any other trauma also, the results of the free radicals. So it's very, very important to focus and to deal with the free radicals. Now, the way of dealing with the free radicals, just the introduction of the good nutrition. Having the very good nutrition, this one ensures you to have a very good health. Now, the good nutrition, this one is the good nutrition. This refers to have those groups of the diet of the food in accordingly, by the way, a balanced diet, simply by the balanced diet, having those groups of the foods in sufficient amount, but also the good nutrition that ensures that you will have enough nutrients to your body. So it's very, very important to have a good nutrition, but also these are the some few essential foods for men's health. Just because of the time, we are running out of the time, but I'm sure that we can just cover it within the normal time. We have the essential foods for men, and we have tomatoes. They are very important. They are very important to focus. In combating or in reducing the prostate enlargement and any other prostate conditions. Very, very, very important. We have blueberries. They are very important, even for the protection, for the immunity. We have eggs. We have these eggs. They are very, very important. We have salmon. We have another pomegranate juice. We have broccoli and the garlic. Garlic and oysters. These are the foods very important for men's health. And as a matter of fact, having this good, these foods, or just maintain this one in your diet, you will ensure to have a very good health. So very, very important to have this one. But also, we have these minerals like zinc. Zinc is very, very important for the sperm production, but not only sperm production, but even for the prostate function. So we have some, this one, so palmetto, they're very important to you. We have veggies and everything. Lycopene from tomatoes, very, very important to our health. So it's very important to include it in your health. Now, we also have these nutrients, 10 nutrients for healthy sperm. It's very, very important to focus on this one. So in your diet, make sure that we consider these are ten elements. That being water, we have folic acid, very, very important. We have maca, very important for sperm, for healthy sperm. But also we have zinc, selenium, essential fat acid. We have a group of vitamins which are very, very important for the sperm, for the healthy sperms. But also we have amino acid. Those are the things that we have to consider them in our diet. But also, these are the things that we must focus so as we can have a good health. One of it just being surrounded. These are the factors we have to consider so as we can live in a very good health. We have to reduce the use of alcohol, the use of the drugs, tobacco, and everything. Yeah, because just diet, the very good diet. Those are the things that we have to consider them in our normal life. But also, as I said earlier, as the man health, very, very important to balancing these health issues and money. It's very, very important because without good health, then you cannot have money. But having the very having enough money, you can also have a very good health. Very, very important to balance these two things. Now, by balance these two things, they will ensure us with a very good health. Now, as a matter of fact, just to maintain this, I've been working with an American company, which at one point helped me to balance. And from here, I will share with you some experiences on health issues. And of course, we have a nutrition supplements, and an American company has been helping so many people to have a very good health, but also not only health, but also to have enough money. But today I'll focus on how to have a very good health. Aloe Vera company, rather Forever Living product, than American company having as leading in this world for producing aloe vera products, but also it has a very good product which have been scientifically proved, and for the products they have paraben free. The American these products, but also they have been approved with halal, so that they are very good health products to use for anybody. But the very good things of these products, they have 100% money back guarantee. Those are the advantages of the Forever Aloe Vera products. But also the aloe vera products, it produces so many different products, but one of it being aloe vera. Aloe vera is the very strong, very big, is the major product for this company. But we all know the importance of aloe vera, but the aloe vera has its function. The function of aloe vera in our health issues, that simply it ensures the growth of the cell. It protects the cellular growth, but also the aloe vera has assisted helps in digestive issues. So simply aloe vera has the enough nutrients, have amino acids, have the minerals, but also aloe vera, it helps and supports our body system. It controls diabetes, aloe vera, but aloe vera Forever Living, it also boosts our immunity. Aloe vera also, it also helps in blood circulation, but also aloe vera does the fact, it has its very major function of combating those free radicals, eradicating the free radicals, simply the toxins. So having the aloe vera in your normal daily life ensures you with a very good cellular growth, together with good the digestive system, immunity system, but also the blood circulatory system. So it's very, very important to maintain. But also aloe vera has the function of reducing of combating those anti-aging issues. But also we have another very important program, a product from aloe vera. This one is the cleansing program, a clean 9 program, very important for maintaining our health. And we have a very good number of people that have been using this program. A clean 9 program, this one is the very important for cleansing, for detoxification. It helps you, it helps you in reducing, you reduce some weight and everything, but also in detoxification or in combating those free radicals. Now, if you really want to reduce some weight, this one is the program that you can start with using it, and it will give you a very good results using this way. So it maintains a good proper blood circulation, but also it assists you in immunity building. And we have a very good, we have some people that have been using this one. These are my good friends that have been using this Clean 9 program. You know, as we said earlier, overweight has been the very vital or big reason to, at the source of the disease and everything. So this one, are some people that they challenged themselves to use this program, so as they now look good, healthier. Even their skin is now glowing. You can see very different people. See, these are the people that I know that have been using this program. We have also another product to maintain and our health. This one is Argy Plus. Argy Plus is an amino acid specifically for the blood issues. It has an amino acid, and due to its function, it helps to dilate the blood vessels and allow the nutrients to pass through and to go to different places of the body. Because after dilation of the blood vessels, because it has a very good nutrients thereafter, it has its effect to the skin, it has its effect to the joints, but also because of the dilatation of the blood vessels, it also supports and improve sexual issues. It also have the effect on brain and every corner of our body. Why? Because it has these factors. Arg plus, it has some vitamins. It also has some folic acid. It also has some this red wine extract, very important for the blood functions and blood vessels also. But also the berry family, very important for the maintaining of blood vessels, and also the skin itself. But also it has an anti-aging effect. So Arg plus is very, very important for anyone who want to look good, to have a very to look young also. So Arg plus is very, very important. Now you can see the Arg plus is not Arg plus also maintain the blood glucose level in a very it maintain blood glucose level. It combat some free radicals, Arg plus. So anyone, it has an anti-aging hormones, as I said earlier. So Arg plus is for everyone. So it's very important to use Arg plus. And of course the Arg plus, you can take it daily. But also we have another supplement. This is Arctic Sea from Forever Living. Arctic Sea is very important for the cholesterol regulation. It also balances those are good and bad cholesterol. But also Arctic Sea is very important for the blood, for the brain growth. So you know that as the man, we need to have a very good brain development. We really need to have a blood circulation so as we can live healthy. But also this fish oil, it also have an effect on the skin. It also have an effect on the prostate growth. So using the Arctic Sea from Forever Living, being very good, very natural, it's very healthy to everyone. So for us, it also help in regulating a blood pressure. By the way, also it also have an effect on the on the skin. Yeah. So Arctic Sea is very important for mood booster. We have people that maybe some people they can have a stress. Those people who are stressed, like by using the Arctic Sea, it's important to them. But also it improves our vision and their joints for mobility and the function of the joints. Also Arctic Sea has its function on the joint. So Arctic Sea, it's very strong, very good for anyone. By the way, it also prevents some wrinkles. I know the people some majority, we don't like to look older. So by using the Arctic Sea, one of the products that it can help us for that one. We also have another very strong, very good product, Multimarker. Multimarker is very vital, very important for the fertility. It enhances the libido, but also maintain good reproductive system and support sexual performance. So Multimarker, it's for us, for you, for me, for anybody can just use the Multimarker. But also Multimarker, it balances the hormones. And by balancing the hormones, and for those people with premature ejaculation and erectile dysfunction, it has been proven that is the one of the very good products for that. So Multimarker is very important. But of course, using the Multimarker, you can see the results, the outcomes. People, they can know that you can see this one is the very good result, the outcome of Multimarker. As they're using the Multimarker, you can feel it. But also we have a vitalizer for men, very important for the prostate enlargement, for the maintaining the prostate enlargement, but also the semen and the prostate, I mean the sperm production. Multimarker has the potential of maintaining the hormones for the man. So multimarker is very, very important for multimarker to also maintain the hormone issues, the libido, combat with free radicals, prostate health issues. So vitalize for men is very important for the issues of the urinary system. So vitalize one of the very strong, very important products for men also, for maintaining very good health. Why? Because it also has coenzyme. Coenzyme is very important for health, for man's health, but also it also has some minerals, very important for the production of the sperms and the maintaining of the very good sperms. So vitalize for men, very important for everyone. But also this one is the testimony. It's written in the local language, but we can see by using these three products, you can see the pressure was reduced from 171 of 106 to 128. So these products, they regulate the blood pressure very good. So, but just they're not specifically for the diseases, just they're specifically for anybody who want to maintain and having the very good health then. So these products, they are there for you, for me, for anyone also. But also we have people that we have this vanilla ultralight, it's protein, and very important to anybody, but specifically for man, whatever light ultra, it has proteins, as I said earlier, and the proteins are very important for the muscle growth and muscle support. So using the vanilla, if you want to look good, you want to look masculine, but then you have to use you can ensure the vanilla in your diet or in your daily use, but also vanilla, it's very special for cholesterol at one point, but also it supports and improve the immunity. People with the very, maybe medical conditions, very weak, maybe with another severe infections, by using the vanilla ultralight, it supports them to improve their immunity, and thereafter, even people that they are very weak, by using the vanilla ultralight, it supports them to have a very good health. But also we have bee pollen. Bee pollen is another supplement for man to ensure a quality good sperm also, but also energy level. It increases our energy level. It has, this one is the food itself, but it's very, very important. It has amino acids, that it has enzymes, it has vitamins. So having this forever bee pollen, it ensures a very, sufficient immunity to your body. But also stress control, it's one of it, just helping us to combat those stress and also to enhance our metabolism. So bee pollen is very important also for sperm production and energy increase. So one of it, very important supplement for us to use. But also we have the naturemin. Naturemin is the minerals, multi-minerals, very important to ensure sperm production, but also it also supports and increase our metabolism. But having the minerals, minerals, they are very important even in digestion also. So the naturemin itself, there's some different minerals very important to our bones and the teeth, of course, to strengthen, because it also has some calcium and everything. So it also have the function of to improve the function of the nervous system, the function of the muscle of our muscles, and increase the absorption of some minerals also, or some nutrients in our body. So a naturemin is a very important a supplement or minerals to use for everyone. But also we have another very important supplement, energy drink. This is the only drink that allows you to, when using this one, The only drink that you can drive, and you can drive with the drink, of course. Now it helps us to increase our energy. It also helps us to support our immunity. Fab energy drink, because people that maybe we are stressed, and but by the way, it also support and increase our mood. And we with this one also. For the health issues, for the reproduction issues also, productive issues also, a fab energy drink act very quickly to give you a quick energy because of the of what it has, because fab energy drink doesn't have a harmful chemical. That's what we say, that it's very good to take, to consume it. Now, I mean, you can even consume it daily. And as you drive, you won't get tired. So, drinking fab energy drink, you'll be okay, you'll be fine, and you have a very good health. These are the very short health tips that I shared with you. And with this one, I really wish you a tremendous joy and good health for you and your family. And I really hope this 2020, everyone will have a very good health. Your health is very, very important, and you are the one to take good care of your health. Nobody is responsible for that one. And with that, I know that if you are you really want to use these products, you can contact with the one who just invited you to this program or to this webinar, so as you can exactly know how to get these products. These products, you can easily get them at a very discounted price from our company. The flavor is everywhere. Is everywhere in this world, so you can have the products, you can just use them, so as you can maintain, you can regulate and have a very good health. And having a very good health, you can do anything. Now with this health information, you can also share to anybody. I know that we started a little bit late because of some reasons which are just beyond us, but very sorry for the delay, and be ready to share with anybody this health information. And because when having a good health, you, me, and anybody, we also have a country, we also have a nation, or the continent with a very good hard working people, and thereafter we can also share. You can also benefit with this health information, and of course, as in other part, in the business issues also, you can also benefit. Thank you for your time, and I hope we'll communicate with you some other time. May God bless you. Ciao. Good night.